Hi, guys, Aaron. Sorry for the weird-ass angle and shit, but I'm trying to record and show you at the same time with two hands, because I can't do this with one hand. First part, take this, slide it onto there. Next part, take this, put it onto there. Okay, the reason why you're doing this is so that the bottom shaft, the actual spindle part of the fucking ball joint, has a place to pop out. Okay, it doesn't even need to be this long. You could actually use another chunk of pipe if you wanted to. Okay, that goes there. This part, you go and you stick it so that, see how there's different sizes and shit? Okay, on that back side, that fits into there. Ta-da! Okay, then you take the C-clamp part without anything on that end, and you put it over it. Okay? And it's a slight balancing act as you go and you line it all up. And you go and you line up the top part onto the top of the C. Okay, next you're going to take your big fucking wrench, you stick it on there, and you just barely tighten it. What you're doing is you're snugging it up so that you can check to make sure that it's lined up on top of the ball joint. Okay, now that it's nice and snugged up, I can actually start torquing down on it. When the ball joint finally breaks loose, it's going to go with a snap. And you'll hear it once it goes. There. Okay, you heard that clank? That was the ball joint breaking loose. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and bottom it out. There we go. I'm going to bottom out the top part that doesn't have any adapter on it, okay? There you go. So it's bottomed out. And I'm going to loosen this up. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to loosen it up so that I get a gap, and then I'm going to stick the pipe, a little chunk of pipe, up here. Okay, watch. Okay, loosen it up until I get a big enough gap up here that I can hold it. And take a little chunk of pipe. Nope, not loose enough yet. And stick it in. And any chunk of pipe will do, actually even any round piece of steel, flat piece of steel, as long as it does not go wider than the top of the ball joint. Now, commence with this. And if you're wondering why, there's some video editing cuts, it's actually because I'm photographing while I'm doing this. So, instead of you guys sitting there and being bored off your fucking ass while I'm going grabbing the still camera, I figured it's just easier to edit that shit out. Now you guys are gonna have to use your fucking man hands on this shit because ball joints, the longer that they're in a vehicle, the harder they are to get out. Rust, crap, road crud, all that shit is going to make life suck. No specialty tools except for a hunk of pipe. I think it took like 5 minutes with me showing you guys how to do it and photographing it. Yeah. Anyway, boys and girls, time to see if this shit all fits. Okay, I got my RCV shaft. Now, I'm just mocking shit up, but if you're going to do your final installation, what you do is you put some grease all along the splines, so that when you stick it in, you pre-lubricate the inner seal so it doesn't burn out on you. So, first things first, get this past the inner seal. Get it locked up in my splines. Okay. Red racing knuckle, slipping over this, and strangling. Fucking hammer usage. Okay, a little bit of massaging with the hammer. The other thing I could do is I could take off that 16th of an inch on the end of the threads that was pissing me off. Okay. Studs. Slide that bitch up. The upper. Now, things are going to be a tight fit. Live with it. Okay? Snug up the bottom one. Yeah, I know, technical precise tools, vice grips, and big fucking wrench. But, like I said, I'm not doing the final installation here. All I'm doing is mocking it up. And making sure everything's nice and snug. There we go. This way, I know it's on the taper. And it's not just resting on the nuts. Okay, spindle. Sorry, unit bearing. Okay, so I'm going to index the unit bearing correctly. Slide it on the shaft. And there we go. Tap that bitch on there. And to be fucking honest, guys, it clears it. Okay. I mean, to be brutally fucking honest, it clears it. Okay. Wipe off the grease off my hands for a second, and I'll show you what I mean. Okay. Okay. See that space? Hold on, let me zoom that shit in. Okay, you see the space? Okay, it clears it. Barely, but it clears it. Okay? The point is, it fucking clears it. Now, if your knuckles are... Wow, bad lighting. There we go. Now, if your knuckles have gotten bent, if your C's have gotten bent, you're probably going to have to go and take and clearance the ProSteers a little bit. And let me show you where you're going to have to do it. Okay. Back here, you have the adjustment splines, okay? And you have this little pocket here. Now, if you look, these little notches go much deeper in. What you're going to have to do is you're going to have to dish this out just a little bit. See these little sharp edges? You're going to want to smooth this out. The easiest way to do it, you're going to go and take a 4.5-inch grinder, have somebody else hold it, take this and gently concave this area right here, okay? You can either do it with the ball joints assembled if you don't get it too hot, or you can actually take this, you can knock these roll pins out and do it that way. And I'm Doc Fortin from jkowners.com, and today we've shown you that the Dynatrac ProSteer ball joints do fit. Mine don't require any modification, but I've also shown you how to modify them if you need to. Please stop by the forums. This way you can also see the product review for the Reed Racing Knuckles and for the other items that we utilized on the Jeep today. And you guys have a good day.